It's time for the weekly No Pain, No Gain market update with a team at Payne Capital Management here in New York City.
Good morning. This is Bob Payne, the Chief Investment Strategist at Payne Capital Management. And Friday marked the 31st anniversary of the greatest stock market crash in U.S. history. That's right. Back in October of 1987, on the 19th, the Dow dropped 22%. Now, if we were to have an equivalent drop today, the Dow would be down over 5,500 points. Now, a study conducted at Harvard and Boston University predicts a drop like 1987 could occur once every 104 years. So it's possible that we won't experience another 1987 magnitude crash in our lifetime, or of course, we might have one next week. Since no one can predict the future, no one knows exactly what the market's going to do on a day-to-day basis. See, the markets are dominated by large investors. When they decide to simultaneously get out of the market for whatever reason, the market will drop and in some rare cases, like 1987, actually crash. Now, the stock market actually over the last couple of decades have actually been relatively calm. Might not seem that way, especially after last week's 1,600-point decline and this week's 500-point up day and Thursday's 327-point decline. I always find it amazing how much the talking heads on financial news channels learn so much during the course of the day. The very people who at 9:30 have no idea what's going to happen or why it's happening are then really expert at 4 o'clock when they know exactly what the market did and why they did it. So this week is no exception. Many of the pundits on national TV were pointing to the Federal Reserve and interest rates, China, tariffs, or the turmoil in Saudi Arabia for the recent volatility. But just like in 1987, when the market crashed 22%, the market simply went down because there were more sellers than buyers. Back on Tuesday, when the market went up 500 points, we had more buyers than sellers. And on Thursday, once again, the sellers dominated the trading. So keep in mind, in the short term, the stock market is a voting machine driven by the short-term emotions of large buyers and sellers. But in the long run, it's a weighing machine, and it's all based on economic fundamentals. And right now, they've never been better. But remember, you can't predict, but you can prepare. Be certain that your portfolio is appropriate to the current environment. And always remember, famous quote, that those who cannot remember the past are condemned to repeat it.